Here's something that I think many non-Trinitarians in all their forms, not only Jews, not only Muslims, Oneness Pentecostals, Iglesia Ni Cristo, all forms of Unitarians, Jehovah's Witnesses, something that should boggle their minds, should cause them great concern, grave concern, in fact. The fact that the Trinity, or at least the basics or essentials of Trinitarian thought, or a pluritarian God, right? One God who is diverse in his unity, not a simple, pure, strict, absolute oneness, but a God who is complex in his unity, who is multi-personal, right? A divine plurality was there in ancient Judaism. It is often assumed for many, many decades, even centuries, that since the modern Jews today who reject Jesus are Unitarians, therefore the Jews of Christ's day were also Unitarians. And even the Old Testament saints were Unitarians, like David, Abraham, Moses, they were Unitarians because modern day Jewish rejecters of Christ are Unitarians. But these people deny Christ. They don't regard Jesus as their Messiah. So why would you trust their view of God and his existence and his unity and oneness? Why would you trust in modern day Jewish monotheism rather than ancient Jewish monotheism? You see, Jewish monotheism or biblical Jewish monotheism is the very foundation of the Trinity. We believe that the Lord God of Israel is the one true and living God and Him alone. He alone created the universe. It is biblical monotheism that is Jewish, that's from Judaism, that is the very foundation and the first pillar of the Trinity. I want you to consider this Jewish scholar's quotes. He ultimately denies Jesus as his Messiah and gives reasons for that. But it's extremely interesting and compelling what he says here that again should really bring grave concern to those who reject the Trinity and assume that it's pagan or inconsistent with biblical monotheism. So Dr. Benjamin Sommer of the Jewish Theological Seminary of America said, "Some Jews regard Christianity's claim to be a monotheistic religion with grave suspicion, both because of the doctrine of the Trinity, how can three equal one, and because of Christianity's core belief that God took bodily form. No Jew sensitive to Judaism's own classical sources, however, can fault the theological model Christianity employs when it avows belief in a God who has an earthly body as well as a Holy Spirit and a heavenly manifestation. For that model, we have seen, is a perfectly Jewish one." That's in the Bodies of God, page 135. So he brings forth a bunch of evidence and shows the sources in his book, and then makes this quite astounding conclusion that Jews cannot fault the Trinity. And in an article, he wrote, "We Jews for centuries have objected to the Trinity, have labeled it pagan, have said, well, that's clear. There you can see that the core of Christianity doesn't come out of the Hebrew Bible, the Tanakh, what they call the Old Testament. Really, they are being disloyal to the monotheism of the Old Testament. Actually, I think that's not true. To my surprise, I came to the conclusion, somewhat to my dismay, that I came to the conclusion that we Jews have no theological right to object to the Trinity. Theologically, I think that the model of the Trinity is an old ancient Near Eastern idea that shows up in the Tanakh and in a different way shows up in Jewish mysticism as well." So he's not necessarily happy that he came to this conclusion, but he's being an honest scholar, looking at the evidence, looking at the sources. He came to the conclusion that the Jewish sources, as well as the Tanakh, in fact, lean towards the Trinity and show a divine plurality, that the ancient Jews not only held to a more pluritarian God rather than a simple Unitarian God, and also affirmed the deity of their coming Messiah. So he even affirms that it shows up in the Tanakh. It's in the Jewish scriptures. This shouldn't surprise us when we see the Lord God, our Father. We can call him Adonai or Elohim. The Lord God is our Father in heaven, and yet he manifests himself in bodily form throughout the Old Testament. For example, walking in the Garden of Eden and dining with Abraham and the people of Israel. There's this bodily form and involvement, the angel of the Lord, the commander of the Lord's host, Joshua 5. He's worshipped by Joshua. He has physical manifestations like the burning bush towards Moses, and you see the parallel between the burning bush and Joshua. Take your sandals off your feet, for the place that you stand is holy. This is the same thing that the Lord God says to Moses out of the burning bush. Clearly, the commander of the host of the Lord is equal with God. You see the deity of the Messiah in the Jewish scriptures. He's called Emmanuel, God with us. He's called Everlasting Father, Isaiah 9:6, Mighty God. Everlasting Father, I take basically to mean he's an everlasting fatherly king to his people with an everlasting kingdom. As we see in that context in Isaiah chapter 9, we see the Lord coming suddenly to his own temple in Malachi chapter 3. He's called the messenger of the covenant in that very same passage. This is quoted and fulfilled in Jesus in the New Testament, Mark chapter 1, and I believe other places as well. You see the Messiah, his days are from eternity, Malachi 2:5. You see all this evidence of the deity of the Messiah in the Tanakh. So that's very interesting. The Jews, according to this Jewish scholar who ultimately rejects Jesus, have no valid objection to the doctrine of the Trinity. The plurality of God, a multi-personal deity, is not inconsistent with Jewish monotheism, is not inconsistent with Jewish tradition either. So we need to consider that as people of truth who seek the truth, this is indeed devastating to all forms of anti-Trinitarianism. So even within Judaism, we can have a heavenly father, Adonai or Elohim, we can call him our heavenly father who is enthroned in heaven. The same God can manifest himself in bodily form on earth, as we see in the Old Testament. The same God can fill the heavens and the earth by his Holy Spirit. The same Jews in ancient Judaism can affirm within their own Orthodox tradition in that time that the Messiah, their coming Messiah, would be God incarnate, God or Yahweh in the flesh. And that's very, very intriguing. It's only until the Christianity comes on the scene and it impacts the whole world, and it becomes so, you know, they're trying to convert Jews to Christianity, to affirm Jesus as their Messiah. And only then, in response to Christianity's claims about the Trinity and the deity of Christ, you find Jews becoming Unitarians. You find Jews rejecting the deity of their coming Messiah, trying to remove that and ignore that from their own Jewish Orthodox traditions. Like the two powers in heaven was affirmed and was within Orthodox Judaism. And that, of course, does point us in the direction, again, of a Trinitarian God or Trinitarian leanings, divine plurality. It only became heresy later on when the Jews rejected Christ as their Messiah. So that much of this is a massive reaction to Christianity's claims rather than resting in their own Hebrew scriptures and their own Jewish traditions and sources, which indeed point us in this direction of one God who exists as a multi-personal God, a divine plurality, a complex unity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we see this in the New Testament, fulfilled in the New Testament. We are baptized into the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the name of God. His revelation, his identity, our covenant God is revealed to us in Christian baptism as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, who are parallel to each other underneath that one name and share the very same identity, therefore co-equal as one God. So again, this information should be devastating and troubling to all forms of non-Trinitarians. I'll be interested in knowing their kind of explanation and response to this. I haven't seen it. Maybe they're deliberately ignoring it. They're deliberately ignoring the evidence because it's so devastating. It's so it breaks apart their theological systems and their assumptions that the Trinity is modern and that it's pagan and that it's not Jewish, that it's not in the Old Testament, and it's not consistent with Old Testament monotheism. It breaks it all apart and destroys many claims from people who strongly oppose the Trinity, not just the Jews, but all sorts of Unitarians.